All right, we're at Three Sisters Springs.
Let's go check it out. Cold. Ready? Come on, Kaylin, we're going with you. There's Randy and Annette. All right, come here, I'll help you adjust it.
All right, Mom, we're going in.
The sun's out.
This little guy. Why is he doing that? What kind of bird is that?
I like his style.
Oh, the giant. Look at his big eye. Hey, buddy. What are you doing? Hey buddy, what are you doing? Kaylin, oh that looks cool. Let's see how deep it is.
Okay.
That looks nice, right?
I'll get in.
You're gonna get in? Alright, let's just throw the anchor right here.
too long. No, he's...
Got him. Yeah. All right, put him in the back.
You doing good? Are you having fun? Look, it calmed down.
There's not much current. You can see the bottom.
So you could see when crawling down there from the boat?
Oh, this is awesome. Look.
We've got about 3/4 bucket full.
Randy's out there. He's got a full bag, so he gets the most out of all of us. No, the anchor's not up.
We should move a little bit, though.
I'm going to move just a little bit. Nice it is out here.
There's the power plant. What a perfect day for scalloping.
And the sun's still out. These are all the boats. We're right in the middle of them. Guy's fishing over there. See all the baits on the water?
Yeah, he's way out. Let me pull the boat that way.
Let me go pick him up. I see him over there. We picked them kind of thin over here, so let's move to a new spot.
we'll pick back up in a little bit. But praise God, we're getting blessed with scallops and we're on our Roner family vacation. And if you're watching this, this is what we got going on. We got a whole mess load of scallops. We had them in a 5-gallon bucket, and with the water in there, we got about 7.5 gallons, but when we took the water out, it went down some. But we're doing a catch, clean, and cook here. We rented this house, and the homeowner had a shop vac, and we tried it. It's working okay, but it sucked a bunch of guts up into that thing. So we're gonna have to clean it real good before we put it away. But we're just using a spoon here to scrape them off. And we got them all over the place. And down in here in the bucket, this is our bag so far. There's a couple pounds there. I was thinking about making a scallop stuffed shell and putting like a breading with scallop in it. I think it would be really good. So we're gonna try that. I brought all the stuff to make scallop Alfredo, which I've had before, which is amazing. And we're gonna fry some of them. And the Lord just blessed us with a great day. It's been a lot of fun. We're having a good time. And this is just our first day scallop fishing. So now tomorrow we'll have more confidence. We know where we're going. We got a GPS coordinate. And so looking forward to more fun. All right, this is what we're doing here. We got this with a spoon. And we just scrape the muscle off on this side, and then we open the shell up, and then just scrape the guts back a little bit with the spoon, and then I hand it to Randy, and the shop vac sucks the guts right off of it. I'm gonna try it again. All right, yeah, just pull the guts back a little bit, and the shop vac. One last cast, the pinfish. It's a good snapper bait. I'll put it in here with the other one. Narrate. How'd we do? This is our rental house. Babe, we did better. We got our house limit, our boat limit. I mean, Randy's got his game fish shirt on. All right, man. Let's clean some scallops. We got 10 gallons. We don't have to put the boat on the trailer after a long day of scalloping. We got a cleaning area over here. We got all those, and this whole bag here, and that, and that. So, pretty hyped. Praise the Lord. Smile. Yeah, you're on camera. Come film me making scallop Alfredo. I just put Parmesan cheese, catch, clean, and cook. So this is what we're doing here. We got all these scallops, Parmesan cheese, butter, parsley, garlic, and got the pasta boiling, and then we got some garlic right in here. This is done. And for tomorrow, we're cleaning these. Look, we got some orange scallops today. I'm gonna stuff these and bake them for tomorrow. We'll film tomorrow too and see how they come out. By the way, it's Annette and I's
anniversary today, 17
years. I want to ask you what
come on, Kaylin. That's a videographer. He's Randy. We made some scallop Alfredo last night. It was a success. Now it's about, 10:59 in the morning. We've been eating big scallops. And we had a whole plate of them, and we ate them all up. And I said, man, I forgot to video, so we're doing a whole nother thing to show you all how it's done. I took mayonnaise and some butter, and needs a little bit of olive oil. And I put some garlic powder in there. And we just been putting two or three scallops in each one. And then I'm gonna put this mixture in there. Kaylin, I need two hands to do this, sweetheart. Come here. I'm just putting this mixture in there. And then I'm taking some of this mozzarella cheese, putting that on there. And then thyme panko breadcrumbs. And then just putting some parsley on top and baking them for 10 minutes, and they're delicious. All right, we'll show you what it looks like after. On the table. We're gonna put tinfoil down on the table. The scallops are done. The big scallops. And let's go get the crab and scallop boil. Shrimp, and we're doing a scallop boil. Take two. We're doing a shrimp. Okay, we're doing a shrimp and scallop boil. And we've got the turkey fryer on high. And we've got some corn in there, and we've got sausages, and we've got an onion, and we put this Zatarain's capsicum to make it spicy, and we found a Florida seasoning crab and shrimp oil. And we've got 4 pounds of shrimp that we're going to add to it. Probably stop the boil, because they're pretty cold. There's your dinner.
Oh, goodness. We got stretch that one.
Yeah. Hey, we did it.
All right, let's give thanks to the Lord.
Stop it.
Lord God, you're a good and gracious and holy God. Just thank you for who you are. That's your people. Thank you for being our God. Thank you for our trip. Thank you for your blessing upon us. Thank you for this food. We give you all the honor, glory, and praise through Jesus Christ, in his name, amen. Mm-hmm.
That stabby ring my leg.
Will you just pop that in the way? Careful
you don't cut yourself in this little oil. Oh,
that would be easy enough.
Yes, I know. You're going to like firm it under.
Oh,
careful.
Look at that.
We're hunting for wild persimmon. We're in state property. Are we gonna get them? They look ripe. You gonna climb it? Break that branch off. Just stand on my shoulders. Here, stand on my shoulders. Stand on my shoulders. Don't get hurt, man. You gonna be able to do it? Yeah, here. Put your foot on my shoulder. There you go. There's one on the ground right here. Break that branch off. Okay, we got it. Yeah, that's a good enough. Ew. Nasty.
What a bitter, nasty fruit. Why does a deer like those? Don't eat it. I don't know if that one wasn't ripe or what, but. Ugh. It's got fungus on it. Take it to the boat, let's take a picture of it and identify it. Make sure it's a wild persimmon. Now I'm in your grill. Okay, we're pulling up at a new spot, King Spring. It's not very sunny today. The water's looking clear.
Here, get a picture with the anchor you found.
We ended up getting how many crabs? 10? We got the crab boil. It's going to be hot. I don't know how much to add. We did it by the directions earlier. Throw them in there, Randy. They came from the spring, so just chuck them in. Got some seaweed on it. Trying to get you, that little joker. I'll show him how to clean a crab. Stick the knife in there, take the carrot piece off, break it in half. And there you go. Just wash it and clean the guts out.